This video tutorial, I will explain how to write JUnit integration test and using JUnit integration test, how to test JWT tokens and user ID. Here you can see the class utils, and it has generate user ID which accept length, and this method is responsible for generating user ID with the given length. And from this method, we are calling generate random string method. And in this method, logic is there to generate the user ID with the given length. Now we will see how to write JUnit integration test to test the generate user ID method. Here I have defined the class utils test, which is JUnit test class to test this utils.java. And to do JUnit integration test, we have to apply Spring Boot test annotation and extends with annotation. And here I am auto-wiring this utils object. So when we run this JUnit test case, the Spring Boot server will be start, and utils object will be created, and that will be auto-wired here. And to test generate user ID method, here I have introduced test generate user ID method, which is JUnit test method. Here I am calling generate user ID method of utils object and passing 10, and this method returns user ID, and here I am asserting user ID should not be null, and length of the user ID should be 10. If these two conditions are satisfied, then this JUnit test case will be passed. Now I am going to run this JUnit test case in debug mode. Here you can see the Spring Boot server is starting. And utils object is auto-wired. And here you can see JUnit test case has been passed. Now we will see how to write JUnit integration test for generate email verification token method and has token expired method. This method, based on the given user ID, it generates JWT token, and this method, it will return true if the given token is expired, and it returns false if given token is not expired. Here I have defined the JUnit test method. The method name is test has token not expired. And here I am calling generate email verification token method of utils object and passing the user ID. This method returns a token, and I am asserting the token should not be null. Then I am calling has token expired method of utils object and passing the token, and it returns boolean value, and if it is false, then token is not expired. That I am asserting. Now I am going to run this JUnit test case in debug mode. It is starting the server, and this utils object will be auto-wired. from the token, I am getting a token expiration date, and here I have defined today date. And if token expiration date is before today date, then it returns true, else it returns false. In this case, token is not expired, so we got false. And here you can see the JUnit test case has been passed. Here I have written JUnit test case to test token expired scenario. Here I have declared the token, and this token is already expired. And here I am passing the token to hasTokenExpired method of utils object, and this method returns boolean. If it is true, then token is already expired. That I am asserting. Now I am going to run this JUnit test case in debug mode. And here you can see the JUnit test case has been passed. The token is expired. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more. And here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.